Namaskar friends, this is NJ, host on this channel, continuing our discussion on understanding the 7th house lord's placement in different nakshatras. In this video, we will try to understand what kind of distinctive personality traits you can find in your spouse or what could be the theme of your matrimonial life if your 7th house lord is going to be placed in the nakshatra number 12, which is the Uttara Falguni nakshatra. So guys, the whole objective of this playlist is that, as you know, that in your chart, 7th house tells about your matrimonial life. 7th house lord, whichsoever planet becomes your 7th house lord, that planet gets the department of looking after the affairs of your matrimonial life. And at the same time, 7th house lord planet also tells about your public image. It also tells about your commercial activities, business activities. So I mean to say, whichsoever nakshatra this planet is going to be present in, the nakshatra's power is definitely going to influence, impact your matrimonial life at the same time. Because when we talk about understanding the manifestation of the results of planets, you cannot restrict your analysis only to the 12 zodiac sign, because behind each zodiac sign there is the energy of three different nakshatras as well. Guys, if you will even divide this word, the word nakshatra, so that can be divided as naksha, which can be seen as a map, or nux, which can be seen as a star, and kshetra means region. So I mean to say, the sky map. So okay friends, now what we are trying to do is that we are trying to understand the behavior of your 7th house lord on 4 categories basis the qualities of the nakshatra. So those 4 classifications are: what could be the strength side of that nakshatra, what could be the connected weaknesses, what could be the opportunities which marriage in the form of that nakshatra's energies can bring in your life, and lastly guys, what could be the most threatful or dreadful side of that nakshatra. So okay friends, to begin with, now first we will try to understand little bit about the functioning of this Uttara Falguni nakshatra. So as you know that first of all, this nakshatra is being ruled by the planet Sun. The region which this nakshatra occupies in the zodiac belt is from 26 degree 40 minutes of the Leo sign reaching till 10 degree of the Virgo sign. So you can fairly see that 1/4 of this nakshatra's region falls in the Leo sign and 3/4 falls in the Mercury's ruled Virgo sign. So I mean to say guys, when we talk about the energies of this nakshatra, so even the god which preside on this nakshatra is the Aryaman, one of the 12 solar deity or the Aditya. And in our Vedic scriptures, Aryaman has been described as a god of the patronage, god of the favors, god of good conduct, good ethics, friendship, harmony. So because of which, with the functioning of this nakshatra, you can fairly include all the good qualities which can be found in the world, in the society. Because when we talk about the other nakshatra ruled by the planet Sun, so with the Kritika, the previous nakshatra, there is still a lot of the willfulness attached with it. But when we talk about the functioning of this nakshatra, so this nakshatra has got all the benevolent, all the good qualities connected with it. And guys, as you know that whichever nakshatra we discuss, at the end of the day, that nakshatra just somehow describes the qualities of the zodiac sign only. So I mean to say, when we talk about the Leo sign, which in itself tells about the throne of a king, which tells about the royalty, creative talents, so I mean to say, even within the Leo sign, if you have to understand its functioning, so Magha represents the throne of the king, represented by the Leo. Purva Falguni represents the very opulent or very luxurious or comfort loving side of the Leo. But when we talk about getting your hands dirty, working with the details, being very pragmatic, being very practical, very realistic, so all those qualities manifest itself in the functioning of this Uttara Falguni nakshatra. So okay guys, this was the few insights which I wanted to give you as a part of the general introduction of the functioning of this nakshatra. Now we will try to understand the functioning of this nakshatra on 4 categories. So to begin with, if you have to understand the strength side of the functioning of this nakshatra. So as you guys know that when we talk about marriage opening up new doors of opportunity for you, like, and that too specifically if your seventh house lord is going to be present in this like Uttara Falguni nakshatra, and that too guys, like this kind of combination, let's say for example, is happening that your seventh house lord is friendly with sun, or if even if the seventh house lord is being present in this Uttara Falguni nakshatra, but it is present in the Mercury section, in the Virgo section of the Uttara Falguni, I mean to say from 0 to 10 degree of the Virgo sign, and if the planet, your seventh house lord, is friendly with Mercury, so you can fairly see that whomsoever you will run into, even in the first half of the life, there will definitely be degree of commitment, strong attention given to the words, commitment, pledges, and taking care of each other. So that kind of energies you can fairly see reverberating in the functioning of this Uttara Falguni nakshatra. So guys, if I have to summarize the strength side of the functioning of this Uttara Falguni nakshatra, being your seventh house lord present over here, so you can fairly see this thing that you might head towards a partner or a relationship where there will be too much of the honesty involved, dignity involved, care for each other involved, and marriage can fairly open up new doors of opportunities, new form of alliances, new relationship, good conduct. So that is how you can see energies reverberating in your life. And as I have already explained this thing, that seventh house lord not only tells about your marriage, at the same time it also tells about commercial activities, business partnership. It also tells about the way you see the world, the way you relate with the world. So I mean to say, in from all perspective, the seventh house lord's placement in the Uttara Falguni nakshatra can fairly be seen as a good sign. The only vulnerable part could be that, let's say for example, if your seventh house lord becoming planet Venus, so let's say for example for the Aries ascendant natives and for the Scorpio ascendant natives, seventh house lord becomes Venus, and if Venus is present in the of Virgo, where it gets debilitated, but even if it is in the Uttara Falguni section, and let's say for example Mercury is sitting and conjunct with Venus, so you can fairly see that all the vulnerability which could otherwise trouble the native can actually get diminished with this kind of combination. Now guys, moving to the next section of understanding the weaknesses connected with the functioning of this nakshatra. So guys, you cannot even deny this fact that at the end of the day, this nakshatra is being ruled by the planet Sun only, and even 1/4 section of this nakshatra falls in the Leo sign itself. So because of which, let's say for example, if your seventh house lord is present in the Uttara Falguni nakshatra but in the Leo section, and Sun is under severe affliction, or let's say for example Sun is conjunct with Rahu, then in those kind of situation it could give the native little bit of the egoistic nature. Native might have a helpful nature, but he might also have this habit of showing and realizing someone that, okay, I helped you during that time, and showing favors or trying to put someone under this debt of favor. So that kind of pretentiousness can get added up. But apart from that, this nakshatra in itself carries all the good qualities only. Guys, moving to the next section of understanding the connected opportunities, because you know that with this playlist, I am donning the role of your nakshatra management professor, and we are doing this SWOT analysis of the nakshatras. So guys, I mean to say, if you have to understand the connected opportunities, so I've already explained this thing to you that you have to understand this thing that this nakshatra has got a dhruva nature. This nakshatra is a like, it belongs to the manushya gun, and at the same time the presiding deity is also very amicable, is also very friendly. So friends, the summary is that knowingly or unknowingly, the stars of your matrimonial life, the stars of your partner, is definitely going to take you to new terrains. You will be able to explore new horizons, and some new opportunities, new connection, new favors might get bestowed upon you. So that is how you can see energies reverberating in the form of your seventh house lord being present in the Uttara Falguni nakshatra. So when we talk about the actual opportunities, favors, gifts. So from all of those perspective, the energies of this nakshatra is very positive. So there has been this news today only that Jeff Bezos' ex-wife, she is now getting married to some teacher in Seattle. So I don't know, the lady worth around $50 billion, if she's marrying a normal teacher, so I don't know that teacher's seventh house lord is going to be present in which nakshatra. But yeah guys, this is the kind of world we live in, and the nakshatras and these planetary vibrations just create that aura and energy around us which connect us with all form of opportunities. Coming to the last section, friends. Now, if you want to understand the most threatful or the dreadful side of the manifestation of the energies of the Uttara Falguni Nakshatra, so as you know that 3/4 of the section of this nakshatra falls in the Virgo side, and which is a sign which is being ruled by the planet Mercury. And in today's day and age, all the frauds, all the scams which are happening, that can be attached to a twisted version of the manifestation of the Mercurian energies only. So I mean to say, let's say for example, if in someone's chart you will find 7th house lord to be present in the Uttara Falguni Nakshatra but in the Virgo section, and in the same person's chart if you will find Mercury under extreme affliction, then in those kind of circumstances native might run into a matrimonial life or to a partner where the partner's nature could be little bit scamming, plotting, manipulative. These kind of things can only manifest under the extreme affliction only, because otherwise Uttara Falguni possess all the good qualities only. So this is something, friends, which I wanted to say as a part of my inputs for 7th house lord's placement in the Uttara Falguni Nakshatra. One thing which I want to advise you as a part of the remedy is that just because of the accentuation of the solar energies, so recitation of the Aditya Hriday Stotra, offering water to the rising sun, and even the recitation of the Gayatri Mantra can be seen as a very good remedy to attract all kind of happiness and harmony from the domestic or married life. So for furthermore updates and notifications on the divine science of astrology, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and like my Facebook page. Thank you.